Well, is anxiety running your household? Parenting expert Michelle McVittie joins us with tips on how to deal with it compassionately and effectively. Nice to see you again.
Yes, always a pleasure.
So I can be, I'm sure that there are lots of cases of anxiety, even within parents, right? About, you know, okay, we're coming out of the pandemic restrictions and we're kind of coming back to normal, but what if normal wasn't so great?
You're right. I mean, and that's another thing to think about. The pandemic hasn't helped anxiety, but was there an issue beforehand as well for your child? Because sometimes we weren't aware. We're not aware. These children smile all the time. They do as they're told. They're perfectionists. They've got great friends, but on the inside, they're really struggling. And during the pandemic, we're around them more. We're noticing things. And then the pandemic is like, yes, yes, it's unsafe. Stay in, stay in. And now all of a sudden, it's like, go back to life. And then kids are like, wait a minute, wait a minute. I don't know how to deal with this. And maybe the parents don't either.
Right. And how do you know, what are some of the signs of anxiety within children?
Yeah, I mean, there's that reassurance checking. When they are, I mean, anxiety is normal, right? We don't want to jump into that car to go for the joyride. You know, we might clean a little bit more quicker when a friend is coming over. It gets our deadlines, but it's when it gets in the way. So people present differently, but it's usually when it gets in the way. So you've got a child that maybe is struggling with sleeping or eating. They are ruminating. So over and over again, asking you the same things. Maybe they're regressing in behavior, wanting to stay home with you when they're like 10, 13 instead of wanting to go out with their friends. So there's different ways to see that anxiety, but essentially what it is that it's getting in the way of life. So social skills, going to school, interactions with the outside world, we're not doing extracurriculars, it's getting in the way. A little bit of anxiety is okay.
Right.
But it's when it stops us from doing things.
And when it disrupts the whole family too, right? So what could you do then? Because I'm sure a child isn't gonna come out and say, I'm anxious, right? So are there questions that you can kind of like guide them along to find out like what the problem could be?
Yes, absolutely. And some children will, but they're not going to say, I'm anxious. They're going to say, my stomach hurts, or I don't want to go to school, or I hate math. And you're like, but you get 90s in math. I don't understand. So you're noticing the meltdowns, you're noticing the struggle. And what's going on? I'm noticing like Monday and Tuesday getting to school was okay, but Thursday was really hard. Or I'm noticing you're not spending as much time with your friends. Some children will say things like, this is too scary, or I'm a loser. And we just say, don't worry, you're fine. And we throw butterflies and fairies at it. But let's dig a little bit deeper and just repeat what they've just said. Tell me a little bit more. What made Tuesday a good day, but Wednesday was kind of harder? You can also label the anxiety as like Mr. Worry or the worry bully. That's like at least they have to be four, at least I would say about seven to really get that, trying to dig a little bit deeper.
And just sometimes digging like that, because maybe they don't want to go to school, but they just don't know why.
Exactly. And I think that's a really good point too, Annette. Like this is a really advanced thing. That's why I'm saying seven or eight to be able to externalize the anxiety. But I don't know what this feeling is. So I have a stomach ache. I'm just not going to stay home. Acknowledge the pain. I know your stomach is hurting. What can we do to calm it down? And here's a great example of one of my charts where what can we do to turn the volume down? And we're not doing it in the moment. We're practicing every day. So when the worries and fears come up, what can we do to turn the volume down?
Okay.
When our body is telling us something's up, let's do something to turn it down.
Okay. Yeah. Our time has come up, but you've got
lots
of great advice on your site. It's under Mom the Manager, and we'll get that on our website, chch.com. I'm sure you helped lots of families today. Thank you.
Thank you.
I promise that you'll never find another like me.